So at least 40 minutes you can be with us with it. And as there is a saying, we carry 5 feet to 6 feet of his body. But what rules is not the 5 to 6 feet of the body, it's a 6 inches boneless time. Yes, sir?
Yes.
So when we all came to the UAE, the first passport photograph was the most handsome and beautiful thing. Yes, sir? Every time you renew, what is increasing?
Age.
So the age is increasing, you're in a safer hand, but the photograph increases. Yes, sir? No? Sometimes I keep hearing from the students saying that by chance if the mother's passport goes to the little one, they ask mama who is auntie. So what is last is the balance. Yes, sir, no?
Yes.
And Dubai is such a beautiful place for really enjoying and living a comfortable life. So very first yogic science says, before you balance anything, balance the annamayakot, the right food into it. Yes, sir, no?
Yes.
So I know many of you are following a very healthy, right diet, okay? And going deeper into it, for instructors, there's a different Annamaya Kosh. For students, it's a different Annamaya Kosh. Why? Because a person who is coming into your class, coming with some sort of an history of some challenges, right? So you are training them, so your food should be more healthy. Then only you can listen and then connect to the persons sharing with them. So as an instructor part of it, I would strongly recommend going deeper into the subject journey. And one of the students was online and he was chatting with me in the Canada and he said that, Guruji, can I eat chicken after the Mahat Pranayam? I just told him, okay, let the chicken do the Mahat Pranayam first. And this is how the questions come from a student. Absolutely fine. We are not against them. But one who is growing towards the heights of teaching has to be in a final balance. It's just like role model to your, not the student, but your own self of inner consciousness. How many family? So my request is the trailer should be in Sattvic journey with it. And yes, our yogic science is all about pranayama. Yes, sir. And all of us have read and been practicing the pranayama regularly with it. And why do we do pranayama?
Control the prana.
Fantastic. It's expanding. Fantastic. Let's clap for that. Okay. You can add a little more prana into the clapping also. Well, what else the prana is being given as a and all that leads to
happiness.
Happiness is that. That's ultimate experience. So where does all this lead into that neutral state?
Balance.
Of bringing into balance state. Yes, sir?
Yes.
Why unhealthy called? Unhealthy is for the cells. Somebody has lost the vibration of its function. So when they do the pranayama, it comes back into balance. So any work we exhibit in the world, we require the balancing journey. So pranayama is a natural tuning process. That's what I say. Prana is only, that's a breath, is the only mediator between the body and mind. And as when you share deeper into your students and when you start going into the science of pranayama,
yes,
it has got a very infinite experience. And especially it is much deeper in experience when it comes from the Annamaya Kosha Shuddhi. Yes, sir?
Yes.
Only prana without Annamaya Kosha Shuddhi does not work completely, but it makes them feel good for a temple work. Yes, sir?
Yes.
So, as a trainers, yes, all of you have got wide number of students around the world. So that's where the prana comes with it. And next is the third question, which is that?
Manamaya.
Isn't it? And as just before the lunch, we all had the meditation. Right? Different forms of meditation are being available in the world. So first, thanks to the ARYIC2019, that's Patanjali Maharshi, who has given such a wonderful vast knowledge, which even now not able to decode 10 to 15% of what that great Rishi has given. Yes, sir?
Yes.
Such a vast. It can't be described in one or two generations of knowledge with it. And why do we do meditation? Okay, fantastic. Dharana Sukhi. Let's start with that. Okay. Next.
Concentration.
To make a better concentration, clap for that as well.
balanced mind.
Huh?
To have a balanced mind.
Fantastic. That's
connect with
him. Connect with him. Fantastic. Many answers are coming towards the balancing, right? So the relaxation, insomnia, migraine, they're all only the branches of the meditation. But the roots of it is to
balance.
Right? So it's called as samadhi, samyutti. Going into the self of in the connectivity. And nowadays, where we are more connected?
Screen.
And is it something wrong to connect to the outer world? It's absolutely fantastic. You should connect more outside, but before that, make a strong foundation inside. Every time I pass through that 11 road, I look at that massive, you know, world's best masterpiece, the Burj Khalifa. I really thank for the rulers and the workers who have done that, but I really thank to the one who made the foundation. Without that unseen foundation, you cannot have a broader and a bigger growth in the world. So why meditation is to grow in the world, helps you to grow in the world. How many of you agree?
Yes.
And now, we should be thankful for the Indian origin yogic science, which has spreaded the science of meditation to the worldwide to bring the balancing that together. So how many of you regularly meditate? Fantastic. Most of you are. How many of you know that regularly meditating is good? Then meditate. And you know something is good, you do it. And the fourth kosha is which one?
Vijnana.
Vijnana kosha, is that. And which Vijnana? Intellectual. What is it all about? Intellectual is all about?
Your inner thoughts.
Feelings and
thoughts.
Right.
And the?
Feelings.
Feelings, fantastic. So how many of you noticed, as you started your yogi journey, thoughts and feelings are much settled and deeper? Fantastic. Excuse me because I keep making you raise your hands. Is that okay?
Yes.
Is it okay?
Yes.
I'm again making you raise your
hands.
Fantastic, right? And yes, every thought leads to the chemistry of cells with it. And as a spiritual science is a wonderful tool because there are multiple religions in the world, but there's only one answer. And that's a unique of inward journey for every person. Again, why do we do inward journey?
Because we to connect with our original state.
The true self. Okay. So then? True self. Very
nice.
Then?
To the source.
To the?
Source.
Source of, the origin of it. Fantastic. Very good. Right? And after meeting, what did we do?
We
realize
that we are one with the
universe.
After that?
After
that, we enjoy
experience.
Happiness.
Peace. Happiness.
Happiness.
Bliss. After you eat the apple, what do you do? Digest. You want to give it to everyone.
Yes.
Yes.
Of course.
Isn't it? So why you're all here is because you want to give it to
everyone.
Yes, sir?
Yes.
So before you give, you should be in a balanced state or not?
Yes.
If I tell my child, don't eat chocolate, how do you? You'll see the chocolate on my face. Why my feeling is not in what tune with words which I am sharing. Yes, sir?
Yes.
So before we say, it has to be very strongly grounded in our Manumaya to Vijnanamaya. So unless the foundation is not really strong, how much you pour, it doesn't fit with it. That's what I say. We pour and pour and pour in a bottomless vessel. And we end with an experience of empty. But that's not a spiritual emptiness, it's an ignorance emptiness. So why do we need to be more and more spreading the yoga is not for making that we are spreading to everyone. For us to be more grounded in what we are teaching. Yes, sir? It's a simple reminder. So every time we get a chance to share, it is actually the inner ears of listening to it, which creates a much better balance within our own journey. Yes, sir?
Yes.
Whether you do your work, you run your business, whether you're a homemaker, does not matter. So this energy is very important. So this energy makes a lot of balancing to happen deeper and deeper and deeper. As you go deeper, the final changes automatically happen with it. But there is one small maya, illusion. What is that illusion? When we're learning, the hearts are open. When we start teaching, slowly, the hearts start shrinking and start walking those thoughts through the process of a narrow consciousness, which is called as the science of unknowingly ignorant enlightenment. I'll just take you through that, a small process. So for that, all of you should play this game for 10 seconds. Ready for it?
Yes.
All of you, can you hold your hand this way? Fantastic. Nice. Fantastic. Fast. I said only fast, I did not clap. Isn't it? So this is called as an ignorance which makes us to drive towards enlightenment. Means what? What is stored in the mind, it continues without the permission of the owner. Yes or no?
Yes.
Like if there is no security, anybody can walk here, anybody can go out. Is there a security required for every mind?
Yes.
Is a security required for every mind?
Yes.
Yes. And who is that security?
Consciousness.
Fantastic. All of you gave the inner answer, but for me, it's a guru. It's a master. Because the one who trains the security is called the Incha security. Yes, sir?
Yes.
The one who trains the security. So why we require that guru's presence is for us to be more balanced in our journey. That's why in India, for thousands of years, if the yogic science has reached to 2019, after 5-7,000 years of journey, it is because of the Guru Parampara. Not because of your technology, not because of me being in it. How many of you agree? So next to the Matrudeva, Pitrudeva, the third is Acharyadeva. The first and the most gratitude is to mother, father, and then the Guru. And when we connect to that, automatically this security process is automatically taken care of. And as all of us have read and went through, teaching is a beautiful profession. It gives an immense amount of energy to carry within and carry outside of it. But over a period of time, even though you take bath every day in the bathroom, in the bathtub, for once in a while you need to use the Clorox to clean the fungus, isn't it?
Yes.
So that everyday accumulation also happens to human minds. And it is called as exactly, what is it exactly called, that fungus which every day accumulates unknowingly?
Mind.
Yes. So what is that? Karma. Anything else?
Ego. Is it an ego that I know?
Ego
that I know.
Let's give a big clap for the lady. So most of the time, where do we get caught? In the sense of ego, ahankara. So for that to see, we'll play a small game. Ready for it?
Yeah.
Only three more participants. Ready?
Yes.
Fantastic. Now, right. We've got another few minutes more to go. So how many of you have seen the cats?
All.
Not a Dubai cat. They're very comfortable. Because they get chicken 65. Where's the hand for that? So how many of you have seen the wild cats? Really? Fantastic. Okay. Now for 10 seconds, let's play a small game. And game is simple, so let's take the role of cats and see what happens. Ready for it?
Yes.
Yes. The two cats are ready. Ready?
Yes. Okay.
The time comes now. Relax the hands, relax the shoulders. And you can play this game with the eyes closed. So that will be much better with it. Okay? Close your eyes. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, start. Meow.
Meow.
Meow. Balance and taking us to the cat, right? Now, how many of you enjoyed the role of cat that you played? Wow, fantastic. Now, the last question is, did you pay 100%?
Yes.
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 Yes. Yes.
Did completely came from the heart?
Yes.
Yes.
Let's clap for that, okay? The truth is that it has not come from the heart, it is not 100%. Okay? Because there is no cat in the world who sits like this and says meow. Have you ever seen a cat which has passed through the university with the hands closed? Isn't it? And some cats were eyes closed and opening one eye and looking at the other. So which are the other cats which are performing well or not? And some cats were no motion and no emotion. They were just holding and then walking around with it. So what it says, we feel we are giving our 100%, but actually not. And why? Most of the time our subconscious ego is so strong, that's why to have it, we need a guru. Because we start thinking what I'm teaching is right. So who will certify you are right or wrong? And but what happens? Once the baby bird got a strength in the wings, they start thinking I'm ruling the world. And that's where we start digging the grave. So there is no bird which has flown all over the world alone saying that I won the world. That's what there's a very old saying. Buddha says, the whole world is mine. Alexander also says, the whole world is mine. But there are two different experiences. One is saying, I want to rule the world. One is that, I want to give to the world. And these two are the two extreme differences of what a yogic science brings the balance to the world than a person who just shares the knowledge of yogic. And since all of you are into training and trainers for the so many of your students, I strongly recommend that we, as being the trainers to the community and society, connect to your gurus and be always in line with that, because balancing is very, very important. It's a momentary non-awareness leads to a consequence of a chronic accident. And to bring back into the awareness is what is this yogic science is all about. And my time is up, I think. So now I would like to conclude by thanking to all of you for being this 20 minutes of journey with this. All of you enjoyed the journey.
Thank you.